Going to discuss about the dispersal of sewage effluent. In the last video we have discussed about this dispersal on water by dilution into river. Now we are going to discuss about dilution on sea, that is a deep well injection. E is differ that is also called deep well injection. Deep well injection is nothing but it's a liquid based disposal method, and this is used to dispose the untreated liquid waste in the by means of pipes. We are that is concentric pipes. We are bringing the water into the by means of injection method. We are bringing down the water into the lower level of the geological aquifers, which will not allow the water into the nearby potable water aquifers. Okay, so that is the place which does not allow the untreated sewage effluent into the nearby potable water bodies. It's a the thing that is that the typical injection consists of the concentric pipes which is extended up to several thousand feet down the surface level into high saline water, that is by in sea. In the permeable injection zone, that is confined vertically by means of impermeable strata. Next one is disposal on land. Disposal on land means in the land we are using the sewage effluent for the irrigation purpose. Disposing of sewage may help in increasing the crop yield by 33%. Because the BOD5 of the effluent used for the sewage for farming, it shall not exceed 500 milligram per liter. The BOD of the effluent for sewage farming should not exceed 500 milligram per liter. So the treated effluent used for the farming purpose, that is effluent farming, it is also called as brat farming. Effluent farming or brat farming or sewage farming. So here what is happening, the percolating water, that is we are disposing the water, it is percolated under the water table, is collected below by a under drain system. This method can be used for the irrigation crops. So it increases the yield up to 33%. Here the water is discharged on vacant land which is provided underneath with a system of properly laid under drains. Here the effluent is collected in these drains after getting filtered through the pores. Is generally small, that is small amount, large quantity may be evaporated and the small quantity is well stabilized in the land. So because of the disposal of sewage on the small piece of land, continuously we are disposing on the same land. So the solids present in the effluent may be clogged, the voids and pores present on the surface will get clogged, or by means of filtration process. That is the water, that is the void get clogged. So it the time taken for the clogging will depends upon the type and load of the sewage effluent. But once the void are clogged, because of the free circulation of air will be prevented. So automatically it leads the anaerobic condition, it the development the forces. And the anaerobic decomposition of the organic matter will stop, and anaerobic decomposition, that is organic, that is aerobic decomposition will be stopped and anaerobic decomposition will start. This phenomenon of soil getting clogged due to the sewage matter is called sewage sickness of land.